r/AskReddit, what only exists because of people's stupidity? The tag on the iron that says do not iron clothes while wearing them. I'm late for work but my shirt is too wrinkled. Let me just press the iron against myself. How bad could it be? No good. IT's full of steam. The warning sticker on lawnmowers telling you not to touch the blades while they are in motion. Many warning labels in general. There are toilet brushes with warnings saying not for personal hygiene on them. Do not place child in shopping bag. The law in Pennsylvania that specifically states that you cannot barter infant children. Fruit roll boxes that warn remove plastic wrap before eating. You're supposed to remove those? In the user manual for RVs it specifies that the driver must remain in the driver's seat at all times when the RV is in motion because someone thought that cruise control was autopilot and went to take a shower while on the freeway and crashed. If I remember right, part of their argument against the company was that the manual did not say he had to remain in the driver's seat when cruise control was being used. He fell asleep at the wheel, survived a terrible crash, cooked up this craziness with a lawyer and won a lawsuit because the lawyer felt there was an opportunity because the owner's manual wasn't specific enough in the cruise control operation. All those drug commercials that tell you not to take said drug if you're allergic to it. Imagine knowing you're allergic to a drug and still taking it. I worked at Cabela's for years and they carry a product called the butt out and it's a tool a hunter would use to remove the anus from a deer. On the back of the packaging in the bottom corner is a warning stating not for sexual use. Warning labels telling you not to eat things that are not food. Warning. This battery is not a good source. Not by itself. No. But as part of this complete breakfast. The phrase, do not try this at home. But you know that some idiot at home will indeed try this at home. The WWE has pushed the do not try this at home message for decades. But, if kids didn't try it at home, we'd have run out of professional wrestlers 30 years ago. I always thought it was a backhanded warning anyway. When the Hardy Boys got their first serious push, they ran segments with home video from their backyard wrestling days as kids. That's basically saying, see, kids? If the Hardys can make it from the backyard to the WWE, so can you. Multi-level marketing aka pyramid schemes. While we're on the topic, would you like to buy some Cutco brand knives? When I was a stupid teenager, I went for a job interview. Despite not having a resume at all, they immediately offered me a position. All I needed to do was buy $600 worth of knives and go door to door selling them. It was foolproof and I was going to make so much money. Then, my father refused to let me take that job. I was so angry at him. How dare he? Of course. Now I see how much of a scam it was and how great it was that my father didn't let me fall into it. I also don't think the scam would work so well nowadays. Imagine sending a teenager door-to-door brandishing knives. I doubt my teenage son make it to three houses before the police grabbed him. Warning labels on electric appliances warning you not to use them in a bathtub. It's actually pretty hard to get an electrical hit in a bathtub from a device. Panic buying. This is really a problem. I order supplies for a medical clinic and we are starting to get back ordered on shit we actually need to treat people. All because of panic buying over the coronavirus. Same. We need about 1,000 more N95 masks. They are a one-time use. Anybody has flu-like symptoms now. And that would be the minimum to make sure we don't have to turn people away and send them to the ER over the next few weeks. We have multiple clinics, and all our suppliers are saying 6-8 month lead times. Meanwhile, dumb ducks are walking around the grocery store with them on their head because they get too hot and it's hard to breathe through. The anti-vax movement. The labels on Superman costumes that say wearing this does not enable you to fly. You thought as you decided to read the label of your new Superman costume while you're free falling off a 50-story roof and you can't seem to activate the flight function of your new gear. The ban on Kinder eggs in the US. Are people really stupid enough to swallow those eggs whole? Even if they didn't know about the toy, you can't possibly want to deep throat a ducking egg, can you? Pretty sure that's just something that got rolled into a larger law about putting non-edible items into edible items. Sure, Kinder eggs are deadly, but the law was made to prevent someone from baking a small toy into a loaf of bread and selling it to kids. Well, it might have actually made kinda reconsider their design. With the old pop-off caps on the inner eggs, it sometimes was hard to get them off. So everyone I know used their teeth to get them off. I'm German and Kinder eggs are a staple in the diet here. Those caps are perfectly child trachea sized and did not have holes in them to allow airflow. With the new design, the cap doesn't come off anymore and the risk of swallowing them is greatly reduced. So at least that improved. The warning on strollers: do not collapse while infant is seated. California's Prop 65. It says everything sold in California must have a label warning consumers that the product is made with ingredients components known by the state of California to cause birth defects or cancer, unless the seller can prove that the item does not contain such components. However, nobody can actually say if anything causes cancer or not. So if you sell something in California, you must either pay laboratories to test everything in your product, then provide reports stating that each element does not cause cancer, or you can buy a 1-cent sticker and slap it on your packaging. As a result, everything sold in California, everything, has that sticker on it. Because why wouldn't you just slap the sticker on? We voted for this. I had to explain this whole thing to somebody in a Trader Joe's once. He was really worried that the cocoa powder causes cancer. And I learned that I apparently look like a Trader Joe's employee. I don't wear red polos in Target and I don't wear Hawaiian shirts in Trader Joe's to avoid those exchanges. Warning: may contain nuts. Warnings on packets of nuts. May. You never know. They might be nut-free nuts. Ro. 90% of my karma is this comment. The ducking message on my in-dash display on my Honda Fit. Yes, I know I am responsible for the operation of this motor vehicle. Imagine the car not telling me that every time I start it, me getting in an accident, and suing Honda for not telling me that I'm responsible for the car I'm driving. Sorry man. My cool knife set didn't say I couldn't stab some 67 times with them, so I just had to do it. It's the manufacturer's fault for not telling me not to. R/FASAPM is a direct consequence of human stupidity. There are also a lot of dumb people in R/FASAPM since most of the posts are people getting whooshed. Easily preventable diseases. True. One of my fav arguments from anti-vaxxers is that insert disease here hasn't killed anyone in decades. It doesn't occur to them that the reason for that is because before their generation people have been smart enough to vaccinate for those diseases. The Tide Pod Challenge. Penicillin. Because someone didn't bother to clean the culture dish. The annoying thing about that one is people had known for a while that bread had some magical property that helped prevent infection. Nobody bothered to test it out. We just had one guy stumble onto it because he didn't bother to clean a contaminated sample once he was done testing. TBH, shoddy lab safety standards has led to a lot of unexpected discoveries. Antibiotics are just the big important one. Do not use this drug if you are allergic to this drug. July and August having 31 days back to back like that extra day would have ended with February, but some people just want to watch the world burn. Toilet roll and hand sanitizer shortages. Tabloid newspapers. Meetings that could have been emails. Flat Earth theory. There was a washing machine I saw in Thailand and it said, please do not put children in here. The belief that brown cows give chocolate milk. The debate of whether or not video games cause violence. Labels on peanut or other nut containers that say contains nuts. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.